I consider Arnold not Arnold. I consider him bodybuilding. Arnold is bodybuilding to me, to everyone else. Arnold is what opened the door for us. Before Arnold and Franco, were the first real pros of bodybuilding. Before them, there was no such thing as professional bodybuilding. Now there's maybe 20 or 25 professionals able to do what all of us here are doing today throughout the year. But without Arnold's initial influence and initial onset to the scene, it would never be where it is today.
But if we accept the idea that the sport has progressed in the last 5 years...
Well, it certainly has.
Well, how would you rate Arnold's chances if he was in shape the same as he was before and, say, competing tomorrow?
He'd win.
I think that Arnold would have his hands full if he were to compete now, unless he really became really serious about his training and did all that was necessary for him to do to get in tip-top shape. But if Arnold were able to come back and win these contests after a short interval, it means that the sport of bodybuilding has literally stood still for the last 5 years. This, in my opinion, is not true.
Okay, the first contestant is Danny Padilla. Boyer Coe is the second contestant. Roy Duval is the third. The fourth contestant, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Roger Walker is number five. Roger Walker from Australia. Roy Callender, number six. Roy Callender.
I originally had intended around 8 weeks ago to start training very hard with the objective in mind to get in my best possible shape for a film I'm going to do, which is Conan the Barbarian. And we're going to start shooting the first few scenes in October. And so I really wanted to be muscular because the idea was that Conan was a very muscular, heroic-looking guy and that I should be in top shape. So all along with sword fighting lessons and dancing lessons and all that, I did my bodybuilding. But the closer I came to this competition, the more people started speculating on the idea that I would be competing. And the more I started thinking about the possibility. And so around 3 weeks or 2 weeks ago, I decided, well, I think it would be kind of an interesting challenge, really, to do something in 8 weeks that most of the guys do preparing a year or 2 years in advance.
When I train, it really depends on what body part I train, you know, what I think about. But it always has to be something that has involved in some form or the other with self-hypnosis. You know, I really psych myself up for it, because otherwise it's impossible to squat with 400 or 500 pounds. I mean, it's really hard to do that, and it can be boring. And so what you do is you create a certain excitement, and that's what you think about. You think about your next set, you think about the particular muscle that you're training. You try to isolate the muscle, you try to pump it up, you let blood go into this area and stuff like that. And your feedback then always is that the muscle is responding, and that means growth. Can you pull out the band here?
Pull the
pin
out
somebody,
kid.
Okay, thank you.
Films. Whenever you see a camera around, you always do like this. To make the trauma build up a little bit.
The shoulder's over 100 pounds.
That's right. It's just a 10-pound blade, but you must make it sound like it was 1,000 pounds.
So everybody thinks you're
macho.
Thank you.
Sitzen. Sitzen. 18. 19, du faules Schwein. 20.
Concentration is one of the things that influences bodybuilding more than anything. Focus in, concentrate on one thing, and not, no matter if there's a bomb exploding around you, you do not lose your concentration. You know, it's also a wonderful thing to be equipped with, you know.
Striving after an ideal, in a sense that you're molding your physique, right? You're developing your body, changing the contours and shapes of the muscles so it looks a certain way you want it to look, a certain mental perception you perceive, trying to gain that or trying to make yourself into that perception. There's a lot of mental training involved in bodybuilding. I think also you're cultivating a feeling inside. You have a need, a calling, much like a priest, have this inert need to do something that you must do, and you'll not be happy unless it's fulfilled. And that's where I'm at. That's why I'm here today. In fact, I believe very much that bodybuilding is more mental than physical. Your concern with this, first of all, this mental projection of what you want to look like, what you want to be like, as far as the contour and shape of your body. Your concern with daily feelings of exercises and handles and muscles. You're concerned with putting your mind in the muscle.
Remember also that every man in this competition is already a world champion. To be able to compete in the Mr. Olympia, the first requisite is that you must have won a Mr. Universe title or a world championship. Facing me, please. Face me, please. Chris, this way, please. Tricep pose, please. Turn forward.
I was worried from the time I stepped on a stage for the first round. It's amazing how insecure you get after not being on stage for 5 years. I mean, I used to go out and it was my home on stage. This time I went out and I felt very uncomfortable, you know, being a showpiece out there, you know, being always having people look at you in a bathing suit. I am the kind of a character that doesn't like to expose himself, okay? And whatever you see on stage, that's you, you know? And whenever you watch somebody in a gymnasium, the way he trains, that's an extension of him. And I felt this time I had to expose myself. I had to stand out there for an hour or two and just be compared to all those different guys. And that is what I didn't like at all.
The important thing is that you always challenge yourself, you know, and I'm a strong believer in the philosophy of staying hungry, you know, and really always being hungry for more and being hungry for bigger and better things, you know, and whenever I have achieved the goal, then immediately after that, I ask myself, what other challenge can I put up to try to achieve, you know, and that's what staying hungry basically means. I'm a strong believer also in the Western philosophy of conquering, of achieving, of climbing, of getting higher and higher to the top and all those things. Because that's, in my opinion, what life is all about, is living rich rather than just existing and just wasting away your life, since we only have one, you know.
I consider bodybuilding philosophical, very much so. I question my existence. Why do I exist? Where am I going? I always had this craving for more. I compare this to Jonathan Livingston Seagull. This Seagull wanted to do something different than the normal everyday thing which he was supposed to do, and they urged him to do. He wanted to expand and to wonder and to do something unique and artistic. And not only in the sense for expanding his artistic ability, but for this, in the sense of expanding his awareness. To me, it's the same type of thing I associate with my bodybuilding. So naturally, the dedication I have for the sport is very intense. I'll give anything. I'll give total commitment to do it, because I must do it to the best or better than I can possibly do it to my ability. And that's what it's all about tomorrow night on stage. All year long, I've been doing this, and now, final day, here's here, to show what I've done.